I'm Ted Stoner, Site Vice President at Clinton Power Station. The Clinton Station has been through a lot over the last couple of years. It has been a long time since Clinton has been profitable. The Exelon Corporation has stood behind us during those troubled times, you know, really over the last 3-4 years. During that period of time was also the period of time in which we operated at the highest capacity factor in the nuclear fleet. Then in June of 2016, the company did announce that we would do early retirement. It was a very, very difficult day for myself and all the employees.
You would talk to your families and friends and talk about, you know, not sure what's going to happen. I mean, it went from like the happiest place to the most saddest place. You could feel it.
I felt bad for the younger guys because I was able to raise 4 kids and a family with a good paying job. These kids, I just felt bad for them. It was a mess.
We have approximately 650 full-time employees that work at the Clinton Power Plant. There's roughly 7,300 people in Clinton. You know, so everybody in Clinton knows somebody that works here. We contribute a lot of money as far as to the tax base, to different programs that the community is doing, different outreach groups. What would happen to the community if the plant closed? That's a scary, scary thought. To have to stand in front of everybody and say, regardless of your performance, we no longer are going to be asked to produce electricity. It was extremely difficult. And I got in my car that night and drove home. And I drove home, and when the first 2 wheels of my car hit the driveway and came to a stop, I tried to get out of the car and I couldn't get out of the car. I opened the door and I physically was so emotionally exhausted. I honestly could not get out of the car. And I just sat there and just thought about everything that took place that day. I thought about how I got to go into the house now and face my wife and my children and say, hey, it's really happening. I got to, you know, we're going to have to move on. And I don't know how long I sat there, but I'm sure it was minutes. And my youngest son, Jackson, came out of the house and he heard me come home. And he was just lit up like a light bulb to tell me how his day was at school that day. And I honestly believe if he would not have come out of the house that I'd still be sitting there today waiting for somebody to give me a nudge to say, hey, it's gonna be okay. You gotta keep moving. As soon as the announcement was made, people were writing letters to congressmen. People were getting on the phones. People were telling their friends. Social media went crazy. The community stepped up beyond belief. The employees really rallied. They did a lot to educate the state of Illinois.
This past May, Representative Mitchell and Representative Brady were kind enough to bring a number of Exelon employees into my office into the state capitol. And I learned firsthand of what the impact this Exelon plant has upon this region, not only for the economy, but more importantly for the families.
It was a huge effort teaming up with labor, with the Sierra Group, with environmentalists, with the state of Illinois. We actually did get the bill to pass that allows Clinton Power Station to operate for, you know, the next 10 years.
We're all thankful. We love this plant. We're gonna continue to run it safe and reliable. And it's a blessing that we all have jobs.
It was like won the World Series again. But no, everybody was rocking around, high five, hugs. It was laughing. It was a blast. It was just like you're reborn again.
I tell all my employees at work, I said, you know, your family is the most important thing. My family consists of my wife of 17 years, 3 boys. My oldest boy is Christian. He's an 8th grader. He's 6'3", very avid basketball star. My middle son, Austin, is much more socially focused. My youngest son, Jax, says that he wants to be president someday. The only thing that worries me is I think he could. All 3 of my boys, we play basketball quite frequently. All 4 of us are very competitive. It's usually very joyful, pushing back and forth, making fun of each other to see who gets a chance to win the next time. The reason we come to work is so that we can support our families, and you have to put your family first. What I try to teach my boys is no different than what I try to teach my management staff and the people at the station. And you know, you gotta get along with others. You gotta be able to work on a team. Trust is the most valuable asset, and we need everybody to work together to do the right thing.